We will get rid of bad and ugly buildings and return to the magnificent classical style of Western civilization. We will support baby boomers, and we will support baby bonuses for a new baby boom. How does that sound? That sounds pretty good. I want a baby boom. Oh, you men are so lucky out there. You're so lucky. You are so lucky, men.
What the hell is that? You thought that when we had that first part of the video, okay, you thought, well, that's clearly the insanity he's talking about. We're gonna go around the nation and get rid of bad, ugly buildings. Well, that's good. They really have been a scourge for too long. When I think about the 10 threats facing the American people, I would say bad buildings and ugly buildings, probably 1 and 2. But no, that's not it. I mean, that's crazy. And again, it's random, bizarre. What the hell made him think of that? But it does actually, to be fair, it taps into this weird fascist thing that you might see on a regular basis on Twitter. There are all of these like Twitter troll accounts, probably bot accounts, that all have as their avatar one or another Greek or Roman statues. Have you noticed this? And they're all obsessed with architecture. It's this cultural thing, this harkening back to, it's not even necessarily their culture, but it's harkening back to when things were more beautiful and more elegant and all that. Everything's degenerate now. It's a very fundamental aspect of fascist philosophy. But anyway, to the extent that he even understands that, that's what he's invoking there. But no, but then I don't know if Trump went into this speech planning to say that we're gonna give you money to have kids, or if he just landed in it because he said we're gonna support the baby boomers and then we're gonna have a baby boom and maybe a baby moon and maybe babies bounce. I don't know. He just says stuff, and now he has a policy where it's gonna be checks for having kids or something. Honestly, maybe that would be a good program. A little bit of actual government support for people who've just had a child. You could maybe do like a child tax credit or something. What a novel idea. But when he blurts it out without ever having thought about the consequences of it, they kind of like it. He can throw out random things like, we're gonna get rid of ugly buildings and we're gonna have a baby boom. And I think that that's what they want, not those individual things. They may never have thought about that and he may never mention it again, but they're fine with it. They want politics to be deranged, because the more deranged Trump is, the more clearly different he is than them. And you need to understand that the people in that audience and the people watching at home are different than you in quite a few ways. Some of them probably go without saying. But one of the big ways is every single one of them, whether they would ever admit it consciously or not, deep within their bones believes that the rich are better than them. They're certainly better than you, but they're also better than them. That's why they are so slavishly devoted to people like Elon Musk, but that's why they accept this madness. They think that Trump is really on to something, and he gives them these grand ideas. I mean, they're madness, they're plucked from the chaos winds, but it seems like big ideas. And Ron DeSantis, he doesn't do that. Like, he can do a little bit of the attacking the trans community or something like that, but that's so easy for Trump to steal. Everyone does that. Nikki Haley does that. I don't think that Ron DeSantis can give an insane speech like you just saw. But what you just saw is just one half of this. Donald Trump is not just running to bring back American greatness or whatever. They may say that they like that, and maybe on some level they do. But there's something they want much more than a positive idea of a return to glory. Take a look at this.
In 2016, I declared, I am your voice. Today I add, I am your warrior, I am your justice. And for those who have been wronged and betrayed, I am your retribution, I am your retribution. Not gonna let this happen.
I mean, that's it right there. I am your retribution. By the way, can we just point out, that's like an amazing Christian thing to say. Get me into office because I am retribution in roughly human form. Like, if you poured like a lot of human into in a hefty bag, that's me as retribution. Like, that's what they want. That's what they want. And that, by the way, a lot of them get it. When Ron DeSantis says, you know, it's where woke goes to die, he's signaling to his supporters or whatever, like, I'm attacking all of these communities and everything. But Trump is always going to declare it more openly. By the way, he's also more willing to actually hurt people than Ron DeSantis. Ron DeSantis will do plenty of damage or whatever, but Trump cares even less. He's far more of a sociopath than Ron DeSantis. And these people want an angel of retribution, even if that angel of retribution like cheats on all his wives and all that, not actually Christian at all, doesn't even believe in any of that stuff, doesn't go to church, doesn't even need to pretend that he believes any of that. But he will give them the retribution that they desire. And that is going to be highly appealing, especially when it's combined with absolutely vicious attacks against the other candidates, which we'll get to later on in the show.